Hello, my lovely students. I hope you all are doing well. Today, our topic is money. We use money every day in our lives. We buy things using coins and notes. But how many notes or coins would you need to buy different things? For this, if you look at the notes or coins closely, you would find a number written on it. That number tells us the value of a coin or a note. Let's look at Pakistani coins and notes individually to identify their value. We have coins worth 1 rupee, 2 rupees, 5 rupees and 10 rupees. And we have some notes worth 10 rupees, 20 rupees, 50 rupees, 100 rupees and 500, 1000 and 5000 rupees. To help us with this, let's meet Anna. She wants to buy a gift for her mother. She has collected some coins and notes to pay for the gift. Anna wants to buy a flower worth 10 rupees for her mother. She can pay the same amount using different coins and notes.
To pay for it, we can use 2 5 rupees coins, as 2 5s make 10. A 10 rupees note, a 5 rupees, 2 2 rupees and 1 1 rupee coins. We can count in twos as well, as 5 twos make 10.
Next, she wants to buy a shirt for her mother, and the cost of the shirt is 20 rupees.
To pay for it, she can count in fives, as 4 5s make 20. She can also count in tens, as 2 10s make 20 as well. She can also pay a 10 and 2 5 rupees coins, or 1 10 and 5 2 rupees coins. She wants a new bag worth 30 rupees for her mother as well. For this, she can pay a 20 and a 10 rupees note. As we know, 2 5 rupees coins make 10. So she can use 2 5 rupees coins and 1 20 rupees note. She can also use 3 10 rupees notes, or she can pay 2 10 rupees notes and 2 5 rupees coins.
I hope now you understand how to pay money for different things, considering the value of notes and coins.
This is all for now. See you next time. Bye bye.